and some questions for you. What
Okay.
was when was your first contact with African trypanosomes?
Oh, that's a very long time ago, actually. That was when I was an undergraduate student at the University of Nigeria and Soka as a vet student. And so when we started our clinical rotations, I think that probably was in our third year or fourth year. So this would be around maybe 1986, 87, or 85. So most of the cases that we used to get at that time, especially in dogs and small ruminants, were really when you take a blood smear and then do a wet drop, you will see the parasite. And it was very fascinating to me that you see this parasite on a microscope swimming around. And so that was my first exposure. And then we were told that these were called trypanosomes, and these were extracellular blood parasites. And usually the most of them, I think they were mostly T. congolense, and also we do have some T. brucei. So that was my first exposure to African trypanosomes.
Trypanosomes,
yeah.
Very nice one. And secondly,
yeah.
Prof, what attracted you to the immunology of African trypanosomes or immunology of trypanosomia?
Yes, yeah, so what attracted me was then, I think in our fourth year and fifth year, we started immunology, and they were teaching us about antibodies and then antibodies being able to clear extracellular parasite and stuff like that. And then we were told, I remember one professor called Professor Mohan, so who taught us evasion mechanisms. And he used a particular word. He said that trypanosomes have a sophisticated mechanism of evading immune response, because even though they float around in the bloodstream, they kind of have evolved the mechanism to change their protein code, and so the antibodies are not able to clear them. So that was quite intriguing and quite to me very intriguing. I mean, also at the same time very fascinating and exciting that you have a parasite swimming around, antibodies are floating around, yet antibodies are unable to clear them, and eventually the animals will die. So that made me to think that immunology is really a good thing. Talks about these antibodies, but also we found that some parasites have a way to evade them. So I wanted to find out how could I solve that problem. That's actually what attracted me to the immunology of African trypanosomiasis. And sadly, I haven't been able to figure out how to do that. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. What are the discoveries of your team about the immunology of trypanosomes over the years?
Over the years. So we've been working on this. I did my PhD in African trypanosomes. And then I've also, when I started my lab, I've been working on this also. And so we've made some very important discoveries. First of all, during my PhD was the era of cytokines. I think we were among the first to show differential regulation of cytokines and the differential expression of cytokines in experimental African trypanosomiasis between the highly resistant and relatively resistant and highly susceptible mice. So we show that the pattern of cytokine responses were quite different. I still believe that was a very seminal observation. Then another thing also we found was, we were among the first to show that, in fact, that the mice that die, the highly susceptible mice that die, are not dying because they are unable to mount a good immune response. In fact, we actually found that if you look at the kind of immune response they are mounting, it could actually be that they are mounting an excessive immune response, and that that excessive immune response may contribute to their death. That's what we speculated. We were not able to show that, But I think the group in Belgium, we have able to definitively show them that, in fact, that excessive immune response is really contributing to death. So we were the first group to really show that, yes, this make that speculation based on our finding, but it was further shown then by the group in Belgium. And then we also showed the relevance of particular type of cell that play a critical role in pumping out gamma interferon after infection. These cells, they behave like macrophages, but they are T cells. They were double negative T cells, but they can stick to plastic just like macrophages, and they pump out interferon gamma. And of course, you know, interferon gamma is a double-edged sword in trypanosomiasis. It can protect, but also when you overproduce it, it kills. So we identify that cell. And then over here in Manitoba, we also made a critical discovery about berenil. I don't know if you know what berenil is. One of the oldest drugs, trypanoside, that people use to treat animals. The concept was that they killed the parasite by destroying the parasite by intercalating with the DNA, and that then leading to parasite death. So what we showed was, yes, berenil do that. It does that, but it also does something different. What berenil does was actually it contributes to down-regulating excessive inflammatory response and excessive immune activation. And by so doing, when you down-regulate excessive production of pro-inflammatory cytokines, the animals live longer. So in addition to killing parasites, we were able to show that berenil actually does something to immune cells, particularly macrophages, Kupffer cells, and what they do is, and they act through down regulation of MAP kinases, and that is pathway they suppress pro-inflammatory cytokine response. And by targeting this pathway, that you can use suppression of pro-inflammatory cytokine to increase the survival of mice that are infected with African trypanosome. So I think that's quite an important finding too.